I wanted to discuss the key of A today. You know, on acoustic guitar, I love playing acoustic guitar because, especially finger style, you can do it with a pick, without a pick. But when I'm in the key of A, to me, A kind of speaks to, especially to like a rockabilly style. And there's some things you can do without a whole lot of movement that are really effective. So, you know, you see an A played like this a lot, right? But the truth is, for me anyway, I end up moving my fingers around in lots of different positions, just whatever works for me, whatever's convenient. And in this particular version of A, especially if you're someone who's just beginning, there's lots of ways to play an A. You know, we've discussed the transitions up and down the neck before, but I'm going to really address today the first position A and where you can go with it within the context of getting that thumb on an open A string and then playing just the D and the G string mostly, and what you can do with it. You can do a lot with just the D and the G string when you've got that low A ringing out, and I'll show you what I mean. So for instance, as you can see, I'm coming down on that open A string, and I'm kind of got a little ZZ Top thing going here. I didn't really plan out what I was going to do on this particular lesson. I just thought I'll just play a little bit. And I like to let you guys in on how I feel or what I do when I'm just sitting around playing and improvising, whether it's with another friend or by myself. This is where a lot of my ideas come from for songwriting and stuff. So in this case, all I'm doing is taking my A chord and then lifting my finger up. That's already got a vibe, right? Now you'll notice I'm using these two fingers to kind of to pinch the D and the G string. It's kind of a claw hammer technique, I've heard it called. We've all got our own way of doing it. But if you just work off of just that much right there, okay, don't change anything. Just keep your first finger in that position. Watch all the things that I can do by not even moving the position or the form of my chords. If you're watching me, you can see I didn't really change my positioning in terms of how I'm fingering the chord, but what I did was I moved from the second fret to the fifth and the seventh, and I kind of went willy-nilly with it, you know, I kind of went random with it. Thumb going. Now that's obviously a little boogie, a little ZZ Top, but the truth is that particular groove, the boogie, was, to my knowledge, was innovated by a guy named John Lee Hooker, who I had the great pleasure of recording a duet with before he passed and went to blues heaven. So what I know about John Lee is he would stay on that root note forever and ever and ever, and man, he would ring out some really cool stuff just from staying right on that one, never leaving the one. He was kind of famous for that. So what I'm doing there is, the first thing I want to show you was going to from the second fret to the fifth, to the seventh, to the fifth, to the back to the second fret. So you go, you're still in the root of A, but you see how I'm coming off that? Now, I know from working with John Lee, he got an awful lot out of just that kind of feel. Of course, the boogie, I think Boogie Chillin' was his biggest hit, and he did that back in the 50s. He had that little stutter that went like... Ha, ha, ha! So I'm doing a little... So I'm squeezing these two fingers, these two strings, sorry, the D and the G, and then coming down on the A. Now, if you want to do that with a pick, you can. It's going to sound a little bit different, but you can still do it if you're a person that's more comfortable with a pick. Sounds pretty cool, actually. Pick is a very powerful amplifier, as you probably know by now. So, you know, when you do a fingerstyle, it's a little more... Oh, sorry. So you add a pick to that. So there's a little exercise or a little fun little ditty that you can experiment with just by using that A... your finger on there and moving it up and down, and then if you choose, you can do the. And I'm bouncing off with my second finger and my pinky. It's kind of a vibey little lick there. And I'm raking up with my pick. Thing you can do in A, and you know, it's cool to just, you know, experiment and move up and down the neck too. Try some, because if you're a beginner and you don't really want to move around too much in terms of the chord shapes, you can still get a lot done. It's almost like a slide, isn't it? So I'm going to be, we're kind of excited because we're launching a whole new series of lessons and song courses back in, that's going to happen in January. So Jason and I are really talking about it today, and we're excited to dive deep into some of the songs that were the classic songs we've been teaching. I'm probably going to teach some of my own original music as well. So I'm really excited, and thanks for subscribing to my channel. Ring the bell, and I'll keep you posted on things we're giving away and all the news. We'll see you down the road.
My friend Jimmy has the coolest guitar lessons. Go to jimmydillon.com/free and get all your amazing gifts. He's the best. Roll! Rock and roll! Stay awesome and rock and roll!